All right, y'all. So I ordered a throttle body delete. Ordered the off-brand one on eBay, and I think it cost like $15 or something like that. Got it in. I installed it last night. The lighting wasn't the best, but I tightened everything down, got it all put back together. Pretty easy install. And went to drive it this morning. There was an air sound when my boost got to about 3 to 5. Or higher, it was really bad. And so I came back home and I took everything back apart again. And here's what I found. Okay, so after I took everything apart, the gasket right here had blown out. And I was okay, maybe they just shipped it with a cheap gasket or whatever. I found the new gasket at my local Napa. They are the only ones that had it in. So I put the new gasket in and I used the same bolts. One thing you need to be aware of, and I'm not sure if the expensive one from Sinister and all that do this, but they ship with bolts that are like that. They're that long. And you see that all these don't have a hole cut in. One of them does over there on the other side, has a hole cut out where the bolt can intrude from. It blew out over here. So here's the bottom line. They ship with bolts that are too long. So this right now, as it is, the bolts are all tightened up, but you still see that there's a whole lot of movement. There's no tightening it up any tighter. There's just a whole bunch of movement. So here's what I'm doing. This is the bolt that it came with. These are the bolts that I went to Lowe's and got. Now, the bolts that it come with are M6 by 30. M6 by 1 by 30. These are M6 by 1 by 25. So they're about 5 millimeters shorter. And so I'm thinking that it's going to take up that space and allow me to tighten it all the way up this time. I also bought a package of 6 millimeter washers to take up the space, and if it's too short or whatever, I can put the washers on the original bolt and take up the space that way. So I'll let you know how it goes. Okay, so here's what I ended up doing. I put a short screw in every single one of them except for that one. This one right here, I left the longer screw in because it's more flush. It can still go all the way through. It seats fine. In fact, you can see that there's no movement at all in it. And with this Felpro gasket, I don't think that it's going to I don't think it's going to blow this one like it did that other one. So I'll drive it for a while and let you know what we got to do. In order to do this, man, it's a very easy mod. Take the old one out. I taped it up in case I ever want to put it back on again. Make sure you, word of advice, make sure you put a cover or something over your boot down there so that way you don't get anything in that intake. I did that when I did my EGR delete, and it saved things from going in my turbo, probably about 3 or 4 things from going down there. I've got the worst luck in the world. But I think this one's going to turn out much better than it did the first time. I'm going to put the boot back on there and tighten it down and give it a run. Take care, y'all.